Okay.
During the trip to the hospital, his word revived enough to recognize the voices of white Southern men. He assumed he was being taken to be lynched. In fact, Floyd Mann and two of his deputies were driving Jim's word to a receptive hospital. Eventually, 22 people received medical treatment following the news reports, followed by news reporters and federal envoy John Siegenthaler. Perhaps Southern racists thought that the Freedom Riders, so beaten and scattered, had been defeated at last, but they were wrong again. That evening, citizens, not just in Alabama, but around the country, tuned in to their nightly news and watched as Jim's word, bruised and battered, lying flattened on his hospital bed, delivered a stunning statement. And here it is. And, oops, we need to get the sound going. Okay, cut.